Good. Initiate full sensor scan of the immediate area for any other vessel.
Aye. Lieutenant Palmer.
I can't raise the constellation, sir. I'm still getting the distress beacon, but there's heavy subspace interference. It's almost blocking the signal.
Keep trying. Mr. Spock, full evaluation of the damage to the constellation.
All power plants dead. Reserve energy banks operative at a very low power level.
Life support systems?
Also operative at a low power level. The entire bridge is damaged and uninhabitable. The rest of the ship seems able to sustain life.
Radiation levels?
Normal, but subspace interference makes readings difficult.
No other vessels in the area, Captain. All scanners show clear.
All hands go to yellow alert. Stand by battle stations.
Lieutenant, have Dr. McCoy,
Mr. Scott,
and a damage control party report to me in the transporter room.
Aye, sir.
We're going to board her. Mr. Spock, you're in command.
Acknowledged.
Pressure 11 pounds per square inch.
Filtration systems are out, sir.
The whole communication system looks to be shorted out too, sir.
Kelley, check the phaser bank. See if they've been fired. Bones, you come with me.
Come along, man.
What a mess.
Check the engines. The warp drive, that's a hopeless pile of junk. The impulse engines are not too badly off. We ought to be able to do something with them.
Phaser banks?
Exhausted. They didn't give up without a battle.
But where are they? I can't imagine a man like Matt Decker abandoning ship while his life support systems are still operative.
Computer system is still intact. We can play back the duplicate captain's log from the auxiliary control room.
Matt.
He's in a state of shock. Ready with a duplicate log, sir.
Go.
Captain's log, stardate 4202.1. Exceptionally heavy subspace interference still prevents our contacting Starfleet to inform them of the destroyed solar systems we have encountered. We are now entering system L374. Science officer Masada reports the fourth planet seems to be breaking up. We are going to investigate.
Fourth planet. Only two left now. Scotty, pull the microtapes from the sensor memory banks and beam them aboard to Spock. I want a full analysis, a complete report of what happened when they went in on that planet.
Aye, sir.
We tried to contact Starfleet. No one heard. No one! We couldn't run.
What happened to your crew?
Oh, I had to beam them down. Oh, we were dead. No power or phasers, useless. I stayed behind. Last man, captain, last man aboard the ship. That's what you're supposed to do, isn't it? And then it hit again, and the transporter went out. There they were, down there, and I'm up here.
What hit? What attacked you?
They say there's no devil, Jim. But there is. Right out of hell, I saw it.
Matt, where's your crew?
On the third planet.
There is no third planet.
Don't you think I know that? There was, but not anymore. They called me, they begged me for help. 400 of them. I couldn't. I couldn't.